The Buran, Soviet reusable spacecraft. The Buran, meaning snowstorm in Russian, was the Soviet Union's response to NASA's Space Shuttle program. The first orbital NASA shuttle mission was on April 12, 1981, and was a pioneering achievement, reducing the cost of spaceflight because it was reusable. The Soviets saw the shuttle as a potential military threat, rather than just a vehicle for civilian space exploration. They thought that the U.S. shuttle would deliver payloads into space that were weapons designed to take down Soviet missiles. As a result, the Soviet military began copying the American shuttle design, even to the extent of copying the paint scheme. The Buran began its development in 1976, alongside the heavy-lift Energia booster rocket. On the surface, its use was like the NASA shuttle, capable of delivering payloads into space and then returning to Earth. Under the surface, it was intended for military use, which remains classified to this day. The Buran orbiter launched via the powerful heavy-lift Energia rocket, unlike the NASA shuttle, which used its own engine and two booster rockets. The Buran's engines were used for such tasks as landing back to Earth on the runway. It's said that the Buran was also safer because it had ejection seats. The Buran OK-1K1 performed its one and only launch into space on November 15, 1988. The joint Energia-Buran system was unmanned using automatic control, something that NASA's version of the space shuttle wasn't intended to do. The mission was a success, and the Buran performed two orbits around the Earth. The Soviet Union was in decline around the time of the mission. With no funding left, the Buran program was quietly shelved in 1993 after the fall of the Soviet Union in 1991. Several Buran orbiters were under construction at the time, which survive today, but have been left to rust in extreme conditions and temperatures. The Buran orbiter OK-1K1 was destroyed when the hangar roof fell on top of it at the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan in 2002. The Buran OK-1K2, nicknamed Tichka, which was almost complete, survives in the Cosmodrome. Subscribe for more history videos. Get Simple History, the Space Race, today.
Hey, Simple History fans. Thanks for watching. If you're looking for a way to support the channel and help us create more epic content, consider checking out our Patreon page. You can see upcoming episodes before anyone else and continue to feed your hunger for history. Thank you for being part of this amazing community.